In today's tutorial, we will install, set up, and configure Power BI Report Server for multiple users. Normally, when we install Report Server on a Windows computer, we can access the server using default administrator account. However, we will today create a local users group in our Windows PC. Then we will add some users to that local group. Then, we will allow these users, through their user group, to access the report server. This will allow users to access report server through local area network. Finally, we will use the port forwarding to allow users to access the report server using public IP address. The video tutorial shown in this picture is recommended to be watched with this video. Many steps and concepts discussed earlier are not repeated here. Open your web browser, and in the search bar, look for the Power BI Report Server. Open the official website. Go to the Advanced Download options. Click on the Download button. Select Power BI Report Server, and click on the Download button. Now, wait for the download to complete. When downloaded, run the setup. Click on the Install Power BI Report Server, and select an appropriate version. There are two free versions. Evaluation, which lasts for 90 days, and Developer, which cannot be used for commercial purposes. Select one, or enter the product key, and press Next. Select the location where you want to install, and press Install. Wait for the setup to install the report server. After installation is complete, press on the Configure button to start the configuration process. Enter the server name and instance, and press Connect. In the Service Account page, leave the default settings, which is Virtual Service Account. You don't have to change anything in web service URL as well. Just click on the Apply button to apply the settings. In the Database section, you need to create a database for your report server. You must have SQL Server installed. Enter your SQL Server name, and use the Test button to test the connection. You can get your server name from SQL Server Management Studio. If the test is OK, you can click Next to continue. Simply click Next, without changing anything. This will create a database for your Power BI Report Server in your SQL Server. Wait for the database to be created, and then click on the Finish button. After creating the database, your final step is to active the web portal in the web portal URL page. Simply click on the Apply button to apply the web portal settings. This will not take very long. Once the web portal is active, you can access the web portal using the web portal URL. Just click on the URL to open the portal in a web browser. Refresh the portal a couple of times, if service unavailable message appears. Now, your Power BI Report Server is up and running. From new menu, click on the Power BI Report button. Remember to always use this version of Power BI Desktop with your Power BI Report Server. The version you will download from this link will be compatible with your server. Your directly downloaded Power BI Desktop will most probably not be compatible with your server. And you will face errors when you will try to upload reports designed on any other version. Click on the Get Power BI Desktop to get the most compatible version of Power BI Desktop. Just as shown here, this is a specific version optimized for your currently installed report server. Choose the appropriate variant as per specification of your operating system. And click on the download button. Now, install the downloaded setup. Just follow through the setup to install the Power BI desktop application. It will take some time to install the application. When done, click on the Finish button. If you did not uncheck the launch option, the application will be launched for the first time. For the first time, it is better to create a simple report, without using the external data source. You can manually enter some data, in the Create Table window. This data will be stored in a table, which you can use to create some visuals. After entering data, click on the Load button. Wait for the loading to complete. Create a title for your dashboard. Add a column chart to your dashboard, with name field, in the X-axis, and the profit field, in the Y-axis. Place the chart in the left side of the dashboard. Now, add a pie chart to your dashboard. Add the name field to the legend area and the sales field to the values area. Your dashboard is now ready to be uploaded to the report server. From Save As, select Power BI Server. Make sure that the server is running. Select or enter the server address, and press OK. Then, enter the name for your file, and press OK. Alternatively, you can save the file in your PC, and upload it through the Upload button on Report Server. Let the file be uploaded to the server. When file is successfully uploaded, you will see a success message. Now, you can go to the web portal, and view the file there as well. Just refresh the portal, if it is already open, and you cannot see the file. And here is our file. Let's open the file, and view the dashboard. Great! Everything worked fine. Now let's give access to other users. Press the Windows and R button on your keyboard to open the Local Users and Groups Manager. We will create users here and grant them access to our report server. It is better to create a group to easily grant access and automatically add new members. Instead of granting access to individual users, as we create them. The group has been created. Now, let's create some users as well. Right-click on the Users folder, and select New User. Enter the name of your user. Then, enter the password for your new user. Remember to uncheck the user must change password, and check the password never expires. Add other users in the same way, following same steps. After creating the users, close the new user window. You can view the list of users, in the users folder. These are the two users that you have just created. These users are currently member of users group. You must remove them from users group, and add them to the group you have created, for report server. Members of the users group are displayed on the login screen of your computer. We do not want these users to log into the computer. Therefore, we must create a separate group for report server users, and place them there. Now, both users are the member of Power BI users group, which was created for report server access. We can confirm that from the group properties as well, instead of viewing the properties of each user. To grant access to users, to view the home page, click on the Manage folder, and select Security. Here, click on the Add Group or User button. Enter the name of the user or group, and select the rights you want to grant, and click OK. Now, the users will be able to view the home page and list of reports, but they will not be able to access any of them. To grant access to view a report, click on three dots, and select Manage, and then go to the Security. Then click on the Add Group or User, and enter the name of user or group, select their rights, and click OK. Now, users in this group can access this report. We have granted browser access to users. This means that they can view the report server and reports, but they cannot make any changes. Let's access our report server using the IP address. Enter the name of any user in user group having access to report server, and their password. As you can see, the user can access the report server. Let's see if they can access the report as well. Great! We have successfully created users and groups, and granted them access to our report server with desired rights. Although we are accessing this server through LAN, you can access this server from anywhere in the world after port forwarding. The default port for this server is 80. To access this server, using these user IDs, we need to forward the port 80 first. Access your router, and navigate to Advanced Settings, where you can edit the port forwarding settings. In our router, these settings are called port mapping. Add a new mapping. Enter a name for your mapping. Enter the local IP address of computer where report server is installed. Enter the port used by report server in both internal and external port number fields. Select both TCP and UDP from the list of protocols. Click on the Apply button to forward the port. Now your users can access your server from anywhere in the world using your public IP address. Let's enter the public IP address in our mobile browser. The browser will ask for user ID and password. Let's use one of the user IDs and passwords to access the report server. Now click on the sign in button. And here you go. This means our server is now publicly available, and any user added to the Power BI users group can access this server. Let's open and view a report as well. Reports are also working fine. And with that, our today's tutorial comes to an end. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.